is a good side of it, then there is a bad side of it. And I believe everything is gonna go fine. Now, that is a misconception. Getting to know that there is someone for you is a good feeling. I'm gonna be doing a giveaway soon, so follow me on Instagram if you haven't already. I'll have a giveaway coming up soon. Okay, it's that time, it's that age. We are just getting into our middle teenage and we are just starting to get these feelings and emotions and all of that stuff, and we are starting to understand the difference between a guy and a girl. And you see, that first time we develop a crush, and that girl we had in school in our class or maybe in our tuition center that we used to like, she was so beautiful and we were so dazzlingly like attracted, and like her face was so cute and we were like, wow, she's the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. Oh my god, I'm so so much in love with her and I like her and all of that stuff. And these feelings are developing slowly. And but now understand that age is the age of innocence. We are in our 15s and 16s, and that is the first time you're falling in love, that is the first time you're developing your first crush. I remember my first crush, and if I actually be honest with you, I sometimes think like, what the hell was I thinking? Like, why did I actually go for her? I think that right now, but at that time it was like I was so like craving for attention and all of that stuff. And it's that age, right? It's that age of innocence. It's that age of we are so naive that we don't know the difference between what is love and what is actually what it is to actually like someone, like the feeling of like having someone around, and what is actually falling in love and all of that stuff. We eventually get the courage up to actually go and tell her, and that is one of the most difficult tasks ever, to actually go and tell someone that you like her. And it's not like her, it's like I love you. It's out of no bounds, you're like, I love you. And I would consider it to be cute, if I be honest with you. Now some months go by, you get into a relationship and everything is going good. Some months go by and that charm eventually fades away. See, there is a difference that we don't know at that age. When you're gonna find out there's nothing new left, like you know everything about her family, you know everything about her siblings, you know her likes, her dislikes, talked everything, like chatting with her and exchanging gifts on birthday and all of that stuff. Now after a while you're bored. Now there's nothing new left. So eventually you're gonna start with the misunderstandings and everything, and you're gonna start quarreling and fighting and arguments. And after like 6 to 8 months or a year or two, that's your first breakup. That is the first pain, emotional pain you're gonna go through. Stay here one more time. Remind me what it's like. And let's fall in love one more time. People go through breakups and all that stuff, and they have the WhatsApp statuses filled up. At that time, I'm talking about my age. In our age, you're like, there was no such trend of adding statuses on WhatsApps and all of that stuff. So it'd be like listening to sad songs, and there are so many, like I could say, Bollywood songs and Hollywood songs that I have listened to at that time when I had my first breakup. And I was like so heartbroken. I was like, what will happen? I lost the love of my life and all of that stuff. So into promises that I want to keep promises that I love you forever and I'll be yours forever and only you're gonna be my life, I'm gonna marry you and all of that stuff. Innocence and promises. I did, though. It was bad at the end of the day. Now time goes on, time goes by, the pain goes less, I move along, we get into college, and we get into different things, study becomes tougher, and life starts to just eventually fuck us up in different sort of ways. And we forget all of it, and we grow up, we get into our late teenage, like, you know, our 19s and 20s. Eventually you have grown up, you have changed your looks, and you have a beard now. Girls have longer hair, they're grown ups. You are now turning into a lady from a little girl. Guys from little boys, they're turning into guys. They're getting beards and mustaches, and their facial expressions and looks, and their voice tone is getting a little bolder, and a lot of things happening. And now that thing pins you again, that okay, let's try it again, let's go again, let's try to find someone. Now eventually you've had that experience, you want to give it a shot again. Now you eventually look for someone, and maybe you're in your university, you find someone, maybe in your coaching centers, or maybe where you live, it's not necessary, maybe you find someone online. I had a girlfriend that I met online, and I don't want to get too personal with it. So eventually you find someone, and now you are fortunate enough to actually get into a relationship again, and now that starts off, that kicks off, and you say you think so, okay, everything's gonna go fine. Now I understand, I'm mature enough to understand what is the difference between falling in love and actually having a crush on someone. Liking someone and falling in love is different. I understand this thing, and I believe everything is gonna go fine. Now that is a misconception. You don't understand everything that is happening here. You cannot be into that state of mind that everything's gonna go perfect just because you feel like it. I'm not saying guys are completely honest, and I'm not saying either girls are completely honest. We have good people and bad people. We have people who want to be loyal, we have people who want to cheat, we have people who want to have fun, we have people who want to be committed. And that is for everyone, regardless of the gender you are in. What will happen is, like, after a while, after some time, you start to feel like you are the one giving in too much into your relationship, and you're just trying to make adjustments and sacrificing on things, giving in too much just to make things work out. And you won't admit when you're in that relationship, when you're in that love zone, you won't admit that your partner is not giving back as much as you are trying in your relationship. But you're like, it's okay, I want to make this work out, because I'm in love with her, and I'll just adjust things, and I'll just make things work out. I'm not saying you're innocent, you're making mistakes, you are messing up. I'm not saying you're completely innocent. Do not get me that I, the one watching this video right now, I'm not saying that you're completely innocent. You must have had mistakes too, but I am being on an other side of it. Now you're saying, you see, things are falling apart. You seem to see things are falling apart slowly, and you feel like everything's gonna go bad, and you won't be able to, like, get on things like that. And eventually there comes a time again when you break up. Second breakup happens. Now you are completely heartbroken. It's the same feeling, but now it's a little more intense because you're grown up. You've had those feelings were stronger for her. And now this feeling of breakup pain is a lot more stronger than it was when you were younger. You cannot give time to your pain and sadness because you have responsibilities, you have studies, you have work. That becomes even more hectic. Through all of this, in my recent past, not too long ago, if you go back some videos of mine, I've been through all of it in my recent past, and I actually understand exactly what it feels like, that when you don't even have time to actually be sad. You have a lot of responsibilities, you have a lot of things to do in life that you cannot give time to your pain, your emotional sadness, and all of that stuff. I faced it, and I know how it feels. I know exactly how it feels when things like these happen. Life goes on. After a few months of all of the things I faced, like, eventually you will move on. Life does not stop. You will move on, and things will get better. Coming over to me, like, I'm happy. I'm progressing with my life. I have a lot of things, but I'm happy. and I've moved past it. What I want to tell you guys is that love yourself more than you can actually go to love someone else. If you want to go for it, love your family, your parents, your siblings, your friends. We all have those friends around us that we know that they are going to be the loyal ones. Almost all of us do. I do have a couple of friends that have been with me since school days and they are still with me. And all I want to say is that focus on these people. Because eventually what I want to say is that you're going to find your soulmate, your life partner at the right time. And there is one for you. You don't need to worry. You just need to wait for it. Wait for the right time. Enduring this pain is actually hard. I agree with it. But getting to know that there is someone for you is a good feeling. So what you need to do is actually just wait for that person to come over and focus on other things. Focus on what you are gonna focus on, the life you're gonna give to that person who's gonna come over into your life as yours when he or she comes over. That is the thing you can focus on right now, and that is the thing which will not eventually disappoint you. That is something what I want to tell you right now. I know this video is a little out of context of what I'm making, but I wanted to make this video because I have a lot of people talking to me on Instagram. That is why I'm always asking you to follow me on Instagram, because I am more active there. I'm answering questions there. I'm talking to you guys, I'm doing Q&As, and I'm doing a lot of things. I'm gonna be doing a giveaway soon, so follow me on Instagram if you haven't already. I'll have a giveaway coming up soon. It's gonna be something really exciting, and you know I'm a techie guy, so it's gonna be something related to tech. So there's gonna be a giveaway soon, so do follow me on Instagram. Eventually we're gonna have some more interesting topics that I'm gonna talk about, and I hope you guys like this video. And just follow me on Instagram and subscribe if you wanna watch me work. Give this video a thumbs up. Allah Hafiz.